I think it's mostly about the people who like wearing black and follow satanic rituals and stuff.
Yes, usually that's a notion that everyone has, that Gothic culture consists of people who wear black and who follow satanic rituals. But what if I tell you this? I thought the same thing until I researched about them and their culture. Gothic culture is so much more than the color black, the dark and the destructive people. Gothic culture not only talks about the people and the style, it also talks about other aspects. Do you know anything about the Gothic architecture?
Fundamentally, Gothic culture transformed churches, cathedrals, castles, pretty much the whole of Europe. Back in the 1100s, 1200s, building skills were extremely limited. Stone castles were rudimentary, dark, damp, and cold. Gothic architecture tried to solve these unpleasant problems by building light, pleasant, and airy buildings. Before, architecture was functional, but now it is beautiful. So this is an example of Gothic architecture, where the gutter, where the rain gutter, instead of a simple rain gutter, they have put a gargoyle, so the water comes from the mountain in Gothic architecture. Then there's York Minster in the United Kingdom, which is the largest Gothic architecture in the Northern Europe. One of the fundamental characteristics of Gothic architecture is its height. This all meant that Gothic buildings are quite literally, scale new heights. It allowed them to reach up to the heavens, perfect for churches and cathedrals. Then the next example is the flying buttress. This also make the Gothic architectures very beautiful. Then vaulted ceilings. You find ceilings like this in every Gothic architecture, Then the Hogwarts School of Witchcraft and Wizardry is a great example of Gothic architecture. So that's all for architecture. Now the next slide will be presented by Ishita.
Gothic fashion. Gothic fashion is a culture that's born by the subcultures of the gods. And typically, Gothic fashion includes dyed black hair, black lips, and black clothes. Both male and female gods wear dark eyeliners and dark fingernails. Styles are often borrowed from the punk and Victorian and Elizabethan culture. BDSM imaginaries are also common. Some hand sculpture carpet designers, particularly Alexander McQueen, have been associated with the Gothic aesthetics. This is the video which shows the Gothic culture.
We'll be right back.
lipstick and smoky eyes, and created crazy black eyeliners and typically styled. Though Gautam makeup has been associated with the white powder face, this is usually considered poor taste within the Narada fashion store. That's all about Gautam fashion. Now it's over to Gothic fiction. Everybody knows about literature, and most of you probably don't know that there is something called Gothic fiction. Gothic fiction combines romance and horror and is also known as Gothic horror. The first birth, we saw the birth of Gothic fiction in the novel The Castle of Otranto by the author Horace Walpole in 1764. Prominent features and characters of Gothic fiction. There's a lot of terror, psychological and physical. There's ghosts, haunted houses, the supernatural, hereditary curses and prophecies, etc. Common characters in Gothic fiction are tyrants, villains, bandits, werewolves, vampires. That doesn't mean that Twilight is Gothic fiction. Examples of Gothic fiction are Dracula, Frankenstein, Phantom of the Opera. And now Shilpa is going to talk to you about something that I'm pretty sure all of you will be enjoying.
The subculture that came later.